Today we'll be extracting plasmid DNA from bacteria. It's a protocol that's usually called a Minipreps. It's called Minipreps because we will be extracting DNA from a small volume of bacterial culture. You can also do Minipreps and Maxipreps from bigger volumes, but we won't discuss it today. So to start, you have to start a bacterial culture. For this, we need a culture tube and some media. To keep it sterile, we will be working around a source of heat, and I will now pour some media in the cell culture tube. About 5 mL is enough. We also need to add antibiotic to the media. In this case, it's kanamycin. The antibiotic is needed to prevent other contaminants from growing. This way, only our plasmid, our bacteria containing our plasmid, will grow in this media. And now we have to pick one colony, one single colony from a plate. We also are doing this in a sterile environment. So now all we have to do is to label our tube and put it to incubate at 37 degrees overnight. So now our culture has grown and we are ready to prepare the Minipreps. The best way is to take a 2 milliliter tube and extract plasmid DNA from 2 milliliter of bacteria. You don't have to be in a sterile environment for this step. So I just pour the 2 milliliters into the tube. And we will now have to centrifuge it around 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes, at 6,000 RPM to avoid damaging the cells. Don't centrifuge too fast. I'll actually use another tube of 2 milliliters to equilibrate the centrifuge. And it will centrifuge the cells to keep all the bacteria on the bottom of the tube in the pellet. So our pellets are ready. They're here in the bottom of the tube. And we're now ready to continue with the Minipreps. For all the next steps, I will put gloves to protect DNA contained in the sample from the DNAs that could be on my hands. So now we have to discard the supernatant by just pouring it out. And we only keep the pellet on the bottom. First step is to add a cell lysis buffer. Usually for Minipreps, you'll be using a commercial kit, and all the solutions already come prepared for you. The kits differ a little bit between the brands, but the principle is the same. First, we're adding the cell resuspension buffer, 200 microliters of this buffer. And the point is to resuspend the cells in this solution. So we pour it into the tube And then you can either gently pour the solution, or the easier way is to do the following. And then the pellet is resuspended. Next step, we add the cell lysis buffer. This will pour the membranes open. It will disrupt the cell membranes, and the cell contents will pour inside the into the solution. So 250 microliters of the lysis buffer. And we have to mix it gently to prevent disrupting the DNA. The next step is to add the neutralization buffer. It will neutralize the pH and would also cause chromosomal DNA to precipitate, and only the plasmid DNA will rest in the solution. So we add 350 microliters of neutralization buffer, and you will see that the solution becomes troubled and the precipitate appears. We also mix the tube gently to avoid disrupting the DNA. And now we'll have to separate the precipitate from the solution. For this, we'll perform another step of centrifugation. This time, we will centrifuge at higher speed. Actually, you can use the maximum speed of the centrifuge for this. So in our case, I will centrifuge for 5 minutes at 14,600 RPM. So now our pellets are ready, and we can continue. As you can see, centrifugation separated very well the solution from the pellet. And in the pellet, we'll have all the lipids and the membrane and the chromosomal DNA all precipitated on the bottom. And now we're going to proceed with the next step. For this, we'll need a collection tube and a filter column that are usually provided with a kit. We will have to pour the supernatant on top of the column. So the supernatant now contains our plasmid in the solution. You can now discard the pellet and proceed with a column. We will now centrifuge the column 1 minute at maximum speed to let the solution flow through the filter. Now that we have let the flow through get through the column, we can discard the flow through and replace the same column into the same collection tube. We will now wash the filter with a wash solution containing ethanol. This will keep the DNA bound to the column, but it will allow the rest of the contaminants go into the waste tube down here. So we'll wash twice with 500 microliters of wash buffer. Once again, we centrifuge 1 minute at maximum speed. So we now repeat the wash with the same amount of wash buffer. So once again, we discard the flow through. We replace the column. And we add the wash buffer. So now, once again, we discard the flow through. And now we'll have to dry the column to avoid all the ethanol presence. For this, we will centrifuge 2 minutes at maximum speed without any solution added to the column. Good. At this step, it's essential to make sure that there's no ethanol left in the tube. So we just keep the column. And if you want to check if there is still ethanol left, you can flick the tube a little bit with your finger. There's no droplets left, so it means that the column is ethanol free. We can now take a clean 1.5 ml tube in which we will collect our DNA. So we place the filter on top of the tube. You can wait a minute or two just to make sure that all the residual ethanol evaporates, or you can go straight ahead. So to collect our plasmid DNA, we will now have to add the elution buffer, or you can use just nuclease pure water, nuclease free water. The volume to add depends on the concentration you want to get in the end. If you want a really concentrated sample, you're interested in putting as little water as you can. The minimum volume is about 35 microliters, but you can get up to 100 microliters if you don't care about the concentration so much. I usually do something in the between. So I will put 40 microliters of nuclease-free water. At this step, it's important to pour the water right in the middle of the column and not to touch the filter with the tip. So I pour the water, and now we keep the column like this for a couple of minutes to wait until the water soaks the filter and all the DNA comes from the filter into the solution. Now we can elute the DNA into our clean tube. For this, once again, we will centrifuge 1 minute at maximum speed. So at this point, our protocol is finished, and you can discard the column, and you have your DNA mini prep. Now the only thing that's left is to label the tube correctly. So I will put the name of the plasmid and the date. The best way to label is to put the name of the plasmid both on the tube lid and on the side. And now we can check the concentration of the DNA by spectrophotometry.